website. And, you know, others, I think you guys sort of said, yeah, well, that's a good idea, you know, we'll do one too. And one or two others jumped on board. Of course, what happened is that as January 17th got closer, there was still no decision about whether Saab would be closed or sold. And so this became an opportunity to really support the company and get out there and create some media and create some focus. And everyone jumped on board with that. It really gathered some momentum. And, you know, we ended up with 60-odd convoys, 10,000 people, probably 6,000 cars. You know, it all started with an idea in Holland and it spread everywhere. We had three or four convoys in China. We had four or five in Australia. We, you know, it really did spread everywhere.
And we have some pictures here from around the world. You can see the different occasions. I think you know better than me.
That's St. Petersburg there. If we can we go back one picture? That's the plate that the Dutch Saab Pub had made up especially for it. And observant ones will have noticed plates like this in several places around Trollhättan because the Dutch guys have been sticking them everywhere. In fact, there's one on the front of the spiker right there to our left. So. But that next photo was St. Petersburg, and you can't see the detail here in this photo, but if you see the original image, there is snow falling on these guys, and they're all sitting there in their coats like this, and it just really, the tenacity of these people to come out in bad conditions, and I know you had really wintry conditions here too, was just amazing. That's St. Petersburg again.
I think we have some success from St. Petersburg.
Yeah, that's St. Petersburg again as well.